say, "Hello, Mr. Death Adder." Oh no, my cover's blown. It's the weekend, and he's pretty sure that he's due to be fed tomorrow. So he's already hanging loose, waiting for what strolls by. He is a cool, cool animal. Well, let's see if I can tease him into quota luring. Nope, not this time. Probably because there's no scent to set him off. Let's just let him relax and save his energy for tomorrow. Death Adder Cam. Now, is that a cute face? Now this is the infamous flying Death Adder, so we have to be careful that he doesn't shoot out of the cage. But look at that beautiful face. This is why I like the Laevis species, because the markings on their face is just fantastic. He doesn't quite know what this is. All he sees is the big lens, and it looks like an eye looking at him. But he's been out and about wandering the cage, which is unusual because normally he's undercover. Just a fantastic animal. We'll just back off a little. And having learned my lesson from backing off the king cobra, it's nothing like expecting an attack when you're backing off. Look at that. Isn't that just a gorgeous animal? Certainly one of my favorite species of death adder. Just a stunner. Mr. Laevis is continuing his trek around the cage. I think he's probably a little bit on the warm side. The fact that it's not sub-zero outside makes this room a little bit on the warm side. Although it does only say 72 on the room thermometer. Mr. Death Adder is 87.4, which is rather warm for Mr. Death Adder, which means that he's all revved up and no place to go. But he is a beauty. I am hoping he and the girl over on the other side of the room hit it off well, and she doesn't kill him in the process of trying to mate with her. I'll make sure that she has plenty to eat, and boy, I wish I could devise a snake muzzle to put over her so she doesn't have the opportunity to bite, and neither does he. Now I see a little bit of rapid respiration. That's never a good sign, especially if you don't like surprises, because that means that he's breathing a little heavy to supply those muscles with oxygen to do extraordinary, scary things. So I am going to back off at this point and let him continue to mosey around his cage. This young girl is a representative of the death adder species Lavis, or Lavis. One of my favorite death adder species, the infamous gray beast, which scares the pants off of me routinely, is this species. This is just another, I hate to use the word morph, but a different variety from a different region of Papua New Guinea. Indonesia, that island complex. She's quite striking in her patterning. And really like to see what the DNA between the species are. I think Wolfgang Wuster did a study recently on that, but I think more in line with seeing how related they were to the Australian death adder population. But Wolfgang assures me this is a run-of-the-mill variety of Acanthophis laevis from Indonesia, Papua New Guinea. And one of the most amazing things about this is they always mean business. These guys never mess around, so we'll be very careful with her. I don't want to wind her up too much, but look at that vertical pupil and look at those beautiful scales over her eyes. It really sets the sets a real difference from this particular species and your typical elapid. These guys also have semi-movable front fangs, which allow them to accommodate a longer fang than your typical elapid because it will fold back. Now hopefully when the season comes, I'll breed this one and the gray one, but unfortunately most of the time the males die because the females kill them in the process, but hopefully that's after they mate. I'm trying to figure out a nice way to put muzzles on them both so they can still do the thing but not kill each other. So I'm going to back off slowly, learning my lesson from my encounter with the king cobra. And I'm going to put her back in her her enclosure. Okay, it's time this month for Gabby's feeding extravaganza. I am actually sitting right next to her head outside the cage, of course, and the camera's positioned down there. And here we can see our victim for the day. Now, unfortunately, I'm not liking this camera angle. Because undoubtedly when she goes, she'll block the lens. Okay, I just repositioned the camera a little bit. Not a whole lot I can do when she's primed ready for launch. I don't like putting my arms or my hands or any part of my body in that cage. Ooh, beautiful. beautiful. I hope some of that was caught. Hey, Gab, it's highly unusual for you to catch by the back end there. Very good. How are you, girly? I haven't seen you in a while. I haven't been paying attention to you with all the Indonesian stuff. Is that good, huh? Oh, yeah, that's a nice rat, huh? Mmm. Okay. And there's Gab and her meal, and we'll just leave and let her enjoy her meal.